Good evening, everyone, and thanks so much for joining us tonight for our night of worship. We are so excited and so thankful for what God is going to do tonight and how God is going to move and the specific things that we believe that already God has planned as we think about walking through a special time of worship through song, a special time of just focusing all that we are on who God is and praising Him and thanking Him and having a heart of worship just towards the goodness of who He is. You know, I'm so thankful for the scripture that talks about how God is simply good, and that's who He is, and His goodness is not dependent upon any of our circumstances. Again, it's just the fact that He is a good God, and we can praise Him tonight because of that, because of He's worthy, because of His faithfulness, because of how He is working and moving in our midst. And from the very beginning tonight, here's what I want to do. I want to take just a quick moment to read a brief portion of Psalm 96. Psalm 96 is a psalm of praise that we hear from the psalmist. And listen closely to what it says. It says, "Sing a new song to the Lord. Let the whole earth sing to the Lord. Sing to the Lord. Bless His name. Proclaim His salvation from day to day. Declare His glory among the nations." And then it goes on to say, "For the Lord is great and highly to be praised. He is feared above all gods. Splendor and majesty are before Him. Strength and beauty are in His sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of peoples. Ascribe to the Lord's glory." And then it says, "Say among the nations, the Lord reigns. The world is firmly established. It cannot be shaken. He judges the peoples fairly. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and all that's in it fill with resounding praise." And so tonight, may that be our heart, to sing this song of praise, of honor, again, of worthy of who God is and how good He is and the things that He does for us every single day. And so as we think about this night of worship, we are honored to have each and every one of you joining us through this live stream. It's a special time that we look forward to, and we can't wait and know that God's presence is going to be here in our worship center, but also in the room that you find yourself in today. And so if you're our Ridgecrest family, we want to say welcome to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for being a part of this worship tonight. If you're a guest of ours, we're honored to have you as well and love to hear from you. If you're a guest, you can text us and say, text the word guest to 334-384-8080, and we'll get some information to you and help you understand more about our church. But for both of you, what I would love for you to do right now, if you're watching through the live stream, is to comment and let us know that you are joining us. Let us know that you're worshiping with us. Say, "Hey, my name is Chase, and I'm worshiping tonight with you from your house." And here's something I'd also encourage you to comment. Comment your favorite worship song. Maybe it's a hymn from when you were younger and you remember singing it as a child. Or maybe it was a hymn that we still sing today in different contexts and different ways. Maybe it's a worship song that God's used recently in your life. But take just a minute as we think about this night of worship and comment in the comment section and say, "This song stands out to me." You know, for me, the hymn, "How Great Thou Art," stands so much out as a young child and being in a worship center where people proclaimed how great our God was. And then moving into like worship songs when I was like in elementary school and middle school, things like "Shout to the Lord" and just that moment where you just felt the people of God shouting to Him in song and praising Him for who He is. And then songs like today where "Christ Be Magnified" or "Living Hope" or songs like that that we worship on a weekly basis and we have the opportunity to proclaim how good God is. And so take a minute right now, if you would. Again, I want to welcome all of you and thank you for worshiping with us, but take a minute and in the comment section, if you're watching specifically on Facebook, let us know what your favorite worship song is or a favorite hymn. And as you make that comment, I encourage you to comment back and forth with one another and say, "Hey, I know that song. Hey, I remember a moment in that song. That's a special song to me as well." And so do that for us tonight. It'll be so fun for us to engage with one another through the comment section, maybe on Facebook, and allow us to just kind of worship together in that context. Another thing that you can do for us tonight is take a minute and share this post on the description section of the Facebook live stream, you can click share. And as you click share, I encourage you to just write something out and post and say, join me tonight for worship at Ridgecrest. It's a great way as you and I share this, we have the opportunity for more and more people to engage with us. Also, our pastor tonight is gonna have a special brief message during our time of worship. So I encourage you to prepare your hearts and be ready to hear from his word, from God's word, as our pastor brings us that special message. And as we think, though, about all of this that we're talking about, worshiping together through this night of worship, it's all centered in the mission that God's given us. We have this ability to be here Sunday evening, worshiping through song, so that God will use this night for us to proclaim his goodness, but then give us the strength to proclaim his goodness in the world. And that's fulfilling his mission of reaching the lost, building the believer, and connecting the people of God to the mission and purpose of God. And so as you think about this tonight, I encourage you to prepare your heart. Prepare the room that you're going to be in just a minute as we get to our 1 minute countdown. Get things settled, kind of get the kids kind of in their spots. Maybe get the dog where the dog needs to be. Do what you need to do, but get into a location and a place that your heart can be focused, that you have a specific opportunity tonight to meet with God. And as we think about meeting with God, you know, I see an opportunity right now with someone posting on our live stream that Waymaker is a song that's vitally important to them right now. And that's an awesome song and an opportunity for us, another song to praise and sing to God that he is a Waymaker and he can work and move. And again, that's why we're here tonight. So thank you all for being a part of this night of worship. Again, we believe that this is going to be a special evening. And so I want to encourage you, stand with us, sit on the couch, kneel and pray if you need to, but just put yourself in a place where you have the opportunity to experience God. The first song that we'll sing tonight is The Father's House. And so prepare your hearts now as we worship together.
All right, welcome. Y'all, we are so excited about this, a night of worship. And Brother Ray and I made a video earlier this week, and I said that one of the things that put this on my mind was we've been having some prayer assemblies here at the church. And I thought, man, we need to do this and have a way to gather and sing praises to the Lord. Because I don't know about y'all, but this has been a really tough year. And I think it goes beyond even just the virus, which has been bad enough on its own. But I know that it's been really heavy, and there's been a lot of difficulties in this year. And so I just want to invite you tonight to not miss the presence of Jesus, because he's here. He was here in our rehearsal. He was here this morning. We've been praying tonight that he would be here and he would sweep through and touch hearts and lives and minds. And so we just come expecting something awesome tonight. And my prayer is that none of us would miss it. So whatever it is that you may have come in with tonight, any burdens, any concerns, anything that's worrying you about the future, fear of the unknown, any kind of heaviness that may be going on in your life, I just want to invite you to trust the Lord with it tonight. And let's spend some time here in his presence. All of the songs that we're going to sing tonight have everything to do with the goodness and the faithfulness of God and his victory in our lives because of who he is. And we just want to partake in that. Amen? We just want to spend some time in that truth tonight. So I'm going to pray for us, and I just invite you to take a moment and pray and sort of prepare your heart for spending time in the presence of the Lord tonight. So let me just give you just a minute and just pray and ask the Lord to take these burdens, to take these cares and these concerns that we have. Trust Him with those. Ask Him to open your heart. And after just a minute, I'm going to open us in prayer, and we're going to get going and have an incredible night tonight. So just go ahead and take a minute and pray. God, we love You. We thank You. We are here for You tonight. That's the only reason we're here, is because You're worthy, and Your worth does not change based on any of our circumstances. We thank You for who You are and for what You've done for us. And tonight I pray that if there's anybody here in the room that's having a hard time seeing who You are and what You've done for us, I pray that You would open eyes tonight. You would open minds. You would open hearts. You would do a mighty work. God, we invite You. We invite Your Spirit to come and meet here with us in this place and inhabit our praises tonight. I pray that You would bring hope. You would bring peace. You would bring freedom tonight. We pray that You would do a mighty work. And we ask You to be here with us in this place. And it's in Your name that I pray and ask these things. In the name of Jesus, amen. Come on, you guys stand with us as we worship.
I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for Your strength. My story isn't over, my story's just begun. Feel You won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. Feel You won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. Ooh. Lay Your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house. Check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, You're in the Father's house. Not the end game, the journey's where you are. You never wanted perfect, you just wanted my heart.
And the story isn't over if the story isn't good.
Failure's never final when the Father's in the room.
Failure's never final when the Father's in the room. Your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house. To check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house.
Come home, the helpless find hope. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Prison doors fling wide, the dead come to life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room.
Miracles take place, the cynical find pain. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Jericho walls are quaking, strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house, check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house.
Aren't you thankful we have that freedom tonight? Come on, sing this with me.
I won't forget the wonder of how you brought deliverance, the exodus of my heart. 'Cause you found me, you freed me, held back the waters for my release. Oh, Yahweh. And you're the God who fights for me, Lord of every victory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Fighting for us, amen. Come on.
A cloud by day is a sign that you are with me. The fire by night is the guiding light to my feet. You found me, 'cause you found me, you freed me, held back the waters for my release. Oh, Yahweh.
Torn apart the sea, you have led me through the deep. Hallelujah.
Aren't you thankful that we're held in His grace? Come on, sing this as a prayer tonight.
So here I stand, high in surrender. I need You now. Hold my heart now and forever, my soul cries out. Here I stand, high in surrender. I need You now. Hold my heart, now and forever. My soul cries out.
stand, yeah. Here I stand, high in surrender. I need you now.
Hold my heart.
Hold my heart, now and forever. My soul cries out. And once I was broken, with you love my whole heart through. Sin has no hold on me, cause your grace holds me now.
Hey!
You've been forgiven. Look where my chains.
resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. Yeah. He's resurrecting me. Yeah. Our God is loving. Yeah. The tomb where soldiers watched in vain was borrowed for 3 days. His body there would not remain. For our God has robbed the grave. Our God has robbed the
never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness
our coast like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God.
Together. God, we love you. We thank you so much for this time in your presence. And God, we believe that all my life you have been faithful. And I know sometimes that's hard to say. Sometimes that's hard to believe. We may be going through a lot. We may be walking through a lot. But Lord, we believe that tonight. And we thank you and we praise you for your goodness and your deliverance and your presence here in this place. God, I pray tonight that you would fill Brother Ray with your Holy Spirit. You would speak through him in a mighty way. You would open our hearts and our ears and our minds. Help us to receive your word. And it's in your name that we pray and ask all these things. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you. You can be seated.
Well, they're not done. They'll be back here in just a bit. And we'll praise the Lord and worship him some more in song. When Bradley came to me a few weeks ago and said, Pastor, I'd like to do a night of worship. What do you think? I said, let's do it. And then I began to think, he said, well, we want you to bring a message during that time. And I began to think, what message would I bring? And I began to pray and say, Lord, would you show me the passage and the place and what it is that you want me to share with the people that will gather for this night of worship? And you know, it's been a year like no other, hasn't it? And it's not finished yet. We don't know what may come yet. And as I began to think about that and think about worshiping God and the song we just sang about the goodness of God and the faithfulness of God, through all the turmoil of this year and all the things that we've been through and may yet go through, there's one constant, and that is God. The scripture says, I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the beginning and the end. I change not. The world around us changes. It doesn't surprise God. The things that we experience and the things that we go through are not a shock to Him. Nothing has ever occurred to Him. He's seen it all. He knows it all. And yet He has remained the same. He is the same now as He was 10,000 years ago. And as He will be 10,000 years from now. He is faithful. And because He is faithful, even in the midst of a broken world, and we're seeing just how broken this world is, in the midst of a broken world, there's one antidote for us. It is to praise and worship God for His goodness. To praise and worship Him for His faithfulness. And when we gather in this place, it is an opportunity for us to connect with Him, because when you walk out of this place, the prince and the power of this world is going to try to beat you up. It's going to try to beat you down. All the things that are associated with a fallen world are going to attack you. Your adversary, the devil, roams about like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. And so as I began to think about what do I share, I thought this, I share about the greatness of being able to worship God. That's the constant. He is constant, so our worship is to be constant. Listen to what the psalmist wrote in Psalm 100. I bet you've heard this before. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into His presence with singing. Know that the Lord, He is God. It is He who made us. We are His. We are His people, and we are the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving, and enter His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him, and bless His name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and His faithfulness to all generations. They tell us that this is a psalm of worship. It was about a public worship. It was about the people of Israel coming together after their long captivity. They had been captive in Babylon for 70 years, and God told them they would be, and finally they're released, and they go back to Jerusalem. And we're told they probably were worshiping in a restored temple. And they've gathered with great joy to come into the house of God. No matter what was going on, no matter where they had been, they had come into the house of God to worship and bring praise to Him. And that's important. It was important to them. It's still important today, because worship stirs our hearts for God, doesn't it? Worship isn't just about motions. You know, worship is about your emotions. We sometimes try to overlook that, and we say we don't live our lives by emotion as Christians. We live our lives by faith, but faith affects your emotions. And I've discovered that worship affects our emotions. It stirs the spiritual desires of our heart and the deep longings inside of our soul for God. It affects our emotions. It stirs our hearts for God. I'll tell you, it also stimulates our faith in God, doesn't it? You see, it is in worship that we're encouraged to a deeper and greater commitment to trust God. It stimulates our faith. We connect with God when we worship and we praise Him and we sing. So that's why the Bible says this, that God inhabits the praise of His people. Because when we connect with Him in praise, guess what? We find that He stimulates our desire to trust Him and to walk with Him by faith. Not only does it stir our heart and our emotions and stimulate our faith, I tell you, it satisfies our soul too. There's just something satisfying, isn't there, when you come and you do what we've already done and what we'll do again in a few minutes. When we do that, It satisfies our soul, isn't it? It's like the world is put on hold for just a little while. And our soul is richly filled by the worship because we are made to worship. And so our soul is satisfied. The psalmist in Psalm 107, verse 9 said this, "For God satisfies the longing soul, and the hungry soul he fills with good things." Worship does that. Praise and exaltation and adoration, it satisfies our soul. Blaise Pascal, the great French mathematician, 17th century inventor and writer and author and philosopher, he wrote some of the most profound words I've ever heard in my life. I heard them when I was a teenager. I never forgot them. He said, "Within all of humanity, there is a God-shaped vacuum that only can be filled and satisfied by Christ alone." I never forgot that. Worship is a way of filling that hole because it satisfies us with the presence of God in His rightful place. And the fact is, all of us are going to worship. All of us are going to worship something. It's not a matter of what do you worship, are you going to worship, but it's the question of what are you going to worship. Now, we know the psalmist tells us and teaches us, and God's word reminds us that we are to worship Him. For just a few more minutes, I want to show you something. Maybe you're here tonight and you say, "Well, how can I take worship to a new level?" Let me show you three things that the psalmist tells us that will take your worship to a new level. He shows us in verse 2 that if you want worship to go to a new level, there must be joyful pursuit of God. He says, "Come into His presence with singing." Come into His presence with singing. This is a statement of joy. Come in to Him excited about worshiping Him. Come in to His presence with joy. Pursue Him. It's about an obligation. And by the way, this is a command to come into His presence. It isn't the idea of, "God, you come into our presence." We sometimes treat it that way. We have to be careful because if we don't understand the difference, we'll make worship about us. There's a song that sometimes we sing, "I'm sorry, God, for what I've made it, because I've made it about me, but it's all about You." That's what the psalmist is saying. Worship is all about God. There's a story told about Abraham Lincoln when he was president, and you can imagine the heavy schedule of appointments that he had and to keep every day. And yet one day an elderly woman came to the White House and she asked, could she see the president for just a moment? And so the president graciously consented for her to come in. As she entered Lincoln's office, he rose to greet her and he asked how he might be of service to her. And she replied back to the president and said, "I haven't come to ask a favor." She told the president, she said, "I heard there was a certain kind of cookie that you like, and so I baked you some of those cookies, and I just came to give them to you." And the story says that when she handed that batch of cookies to Lincoln, tears began to roll down his face. And he looked at her, and he said, "You're the very first person who has ever come into my office asking not, expecting not, but rather bringing to me a gift, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart." You understand that when we come into the presence of God, it is not about what we can take, it is about what we can give back to Him. Have you ever heard somebody say something like this? "Well, I went to worship, I went to church, but I didn't get anything out of it." Listen, you didn't give anything. In worship, you don't receive until you give. Because it's not about you. It is about a joyful pursuit of God. By the way, God has assured us that if we will pursue Him, that we'll find Him. In Jeremiah 29, He told His people, He said, "You will seek me and you will find me when you seek me with all your heart." How you enter His presence makes all the difference in the world in your worship. But if you want to take it to another level, not only must there be joyful pursuit of God, I want to tell you there must be worshipful perspective of God. In verse 3, the psalmist says, "Know that the Lord is God." That's about exaltation. The first is about obligation, coming to His presence with joy. This is about exaltation. Your perspective about God affects your worship, doesn't it? Think about God's grace. Think about God's mercy. Think about God's kindness. Think about God's patience. That song we just sing, all my life You've been so, so good. We think about that. God, You have been faithful all my life. When you begin to think, when your perspective is shaped by who God has been, when you think about that, it affects your worship. I tell you tonight, this is a holy place. It's a holy place. This building is a holy place, not because we built it and dedicated it to God. This is a holy place, not because you are here or I'm here. This is a holy place because God is here. And He deserves our highest reverence and exaltation. You see, perspective of who God is changes your worship. I love the story that is told about a member of the British Parliament. His name was Neil Martin. Remember his name, Neil Martin. And a group of his constituents that had come to Parliament, they wanted to tour, and he was taking them through the Houses of Parliament, and he was showing them around. And while he was walking through a particular area across the way, Lord Hailsham, who was the Lord Chancellor at that time of Parliament, and he just happened to be in the same area, and he had all his regalia on, his robes and all his ribbons and his cords and all of that. He was decked out in full regalia, and everybody knew who he was because he really, again, was the Chancellor of the Parliament. And he saw Neil Martin, this member of Parliament, across the way, and when he saw Neil, he simply hollered out across the way, "Neil!" And when he did, no one dare question his authority. The whole group went down on their knees. They thought, "He's telling us to kneel," and they didn't hesitate. They went down on their knees. He was just simply seeing a friend and calling his name, "Kneel." You understand, perspective makes a difference, doesn't it? And perspective about God affects the way we worship Him and what we kneel to and who we kneel to and who we submit to. And you know, the day is coming, and the Bible says that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess. The day is coming when what we're doing here tonight, we'll get to do in His presence, but we'll kneel before Him. We may lay prostrate before Him. I don't know. And we will say, "You are Lord. You are Lord God Almighty." We will say, "We know that You are the Lord. Know," as He says, "that the Lord, He is God," and worship Him. You know, we can kneel before Him in this place in worship. We kneel in our hearts and we kneel with our bodies when we come together to worship Him. It is because we have the right perspective on who He is. But last, I tell you, if you want your worship to go to a new level, then there must be grateful praise to God. Verse 4 says this, "Enter His gates with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and bless His name." Look, the first is about obligation, the joyful pursuit. The second is about exaltation, having the right perspective and exalting Him. And this is about celebration. And it's also really about anticipation. They anticipated coming into the courts to worship Him, into the place of worship, together before Him to praise Him and celebrate who He was. And they anticipated just what that would be like. They were eager to worship. They were eager to enter His courts, and they were eager to offer thanks. We have gathered to worship Him. And because of that, our tongues should declare the glory of God. Our mouth should proclaim Him with thanksgiving. Have you ever noticed when we gather to worship God, we don't sing dirges. We don't sing sad songs. When we gather to worship, we sing and celebrate. Our praise songs and our hymns are songs of adoration, exaltation, worship, and celebration. praise originates in our heart. But listen, it's not designed to stay there. And that's why we should sing when we gather to worship. We should sing with gusto and with joy. Let the glory of the Lord be among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. That's what should happen when we come into His presence. He's worthy of our praise, and He's worthy of our worship. Perhaps the most famous military leader in all of Britain's history is the Duke of Wellington. And he is memorialized in there. I've been in their military museum and in London, and he's memorialized there. He's just looked up to for his great leadership. He was the general that stopped Napoleon. He took Napoleon down at Waterloo when Britain thought their whole nation's life depended on it. The Duke of Wellington. And he was not an easy man to serve under. He was brilliant. He was demanding. But he wasn't one to shower those who served under him with compliments. But he realized kind of how he was. And the story is told that late in his life, a young lady asked him, "Sir, if you could live your life over again, if you could change anything about your life, would you? And what would it be?" And the Duke of Wellington looked at her. He paused for just a moment and he said, "Yes, there's something I'd do different. If I could do it all again, I would give more praise." Well, listen, while we have the opportunity, and while we can, let's give more praise to the one who deserves all praise. In Revelation chapter 15, there is a section there called the Song of Moses. It's a beautiful passage of Scripture. Let me just share a part of it with you. It says, "And they sing the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb." And by the way, you can go see back in the Old Testament the song, what's called the Song of Moses. It was a song of praise to God. And even at the end of the age, when one day they're around the throne, it says they sing the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb, saying, "Great and amazing are your deeds, O Lord God the Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O King of the nations. Who will not fear, O Lord, and glorify your name? For you alone are holy. All the nations will come and worship you, for your righteous acts have been revealed." I tell you tonight, let's continue our worship with great gusto. Let's continue worshiping the God of all. Let's continue worshiping with all our hearts and soul and mind and strength. And let's praise more while we still can. Father, we thank you that you have created us to worship. And we have so much to worship you for. We have so much, God, to praise you for your everlasting love that you've told us that no matter what comes our way in our world, there's nothing that can separate us from that love. God, we praise you because your mercies are new every morning. God, we bless your name because you love us so much that you sent Jesus to die for us. Lord, we bless you and praise you because no matter what's going on in our world, you're the constant. You're our rock and our fortress. We will cling to you. Lord, we praise you and we worship you because we know that the end of the story is really good. And that one day, Father, around your throne, we will see you in all your glory. We praise you for that. And we praise you, Lord, that we can praise you. That our souls are satisfied when we praise you. That our faith is fortified when we praise you. And Lord, that when we praise you, we are stirred emotionally because we connect and we thank you for that. And so as we continue now, Lord, would you continue to inhabit this place? Fill us with your Spirit and inhabit the praise of your people in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Let's stand again as we continue to worship.
Should I ever need reminding? space between all the things unseen and this reckoning. I know I will never be
Aren't you thankful that he's always with us? He's never left us. What a blessing, amen.
And I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind, 'cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Come on, sing it out.
And I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus.
Your name is power.
'Cause your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life.
Thank you, Lord.
Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like a fire.
Come on, sing it.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over fear and all anxiety, to every soul held captive by depression. I speak Jesus. Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy, And Jesus, for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus.
Come on, lift that up tonight. Shout Jesus.
And shout Jesus from the mountains.
Come on.
And Jesus in the streets. Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. And Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus.
Come on, let that be your prayer tonight.
Oh, shout Jesus from the mountains, and Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for presence. I speak Jesus. Shake before you, the demons run and flee at the mention of your name, King of Majesty. There is no power in hell or any who can stand before the power and the
Cast my mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. Body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone. The name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name forevermore. For endless days we will sing your praise. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord our God. Then on the third, the Son of Heaven
of wine, the blazing sun shall pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints, my gaze transfixed on Jesus' face.
Come on, sing it out. Oh, praise the name.
Is my beginning, the line drawn in the sand, the end of all my striving. Now I am born again.
Thank you, Lord.
There Jesus was forsaken, so I will never be. His grace is my salvation, the gift of God, the work of Calvary.
It is done, it is finished. Christ has won, he is risen. Is here. Love has triumphed over death forever.
The cross needs no addition.
His mercy is complete.
Oh, his love is not in question.
The Son of God has spoken over me. It is done. It is finished. Christ has won. He is risen. Grace is here. Love has triumphed.
Sing this.
Strongholds bowing to the Savior, resurrection power over every circumstance. His word stands final and forever. It will not be shaken. He alone has won it all.
Amen.
Strongholds bowing.
Man, let's pray together tonight. God, we love you and we thank you for this time in your presence. We thank you that you are here with us and you are working and moving. And God, I pray that every day and everything that we say and do, we would worship you that with all that we have. And we would never stop. And that all of our words and our actions would bring you honor and glory. And God, right here, right now, in this place, we just say thank you for stirring in our hearts and lives. Lord, we love you and we thank you. And we say tonight, thank you that it is finished. And it's in your name that we pray. Amen. Woo. Can we do one more? I mean, you know, I feel like we need to go out with a bang. Not that that wasn't a bang. That was... All right, one more chance. Give it all you got.
Here we go.
Oh, well, I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. And man's empty praise and treasures of vain are never enough.
Ain't that right?
Oh, then you came along and put me back together, and every desire is now satisfied here in your love.
Hey, sing it out.
Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing.
You believe it?
Better than you, Lord. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you.
Hey, isn't that the truth? Come on, sing this.
Oh, well, I'm not afraid. Show you my weakness, my failures and flaws. Lord, you see them all, and you still call me friend. Hey, hey, 'cause the God of the mountain is the God of the valley. Yes, he is.
shout of praise to the Lord one more time. Come on. Woo! Thank you guys so much for being here with us tonight. It is our prayer that you would take this with you and you would let this be at the front of your mind as you go your separate ways this week. We love you. Thank you all for worshiping with us tonight. Y'all are dismissed.
Hey, everyone. Thank you so much for being a part of this special evening. What a night it has been as we have lifted high the name of Jesus through song, the focus of his word, and just been encouraged by who he is, what he's done, his faithfulness, how he's continually and will always be faithful, and ultimately how he can be trusted in all the details as he is working in our lives in every circumstance. Again, we can't say thank you enough for tuning in and just thankful for our team that led us tonight in worship through song. And we hope that it's been a blessing to you so that you can go and let this week be a week that you say, God, use me. Let it be an encouragement for what you've experienced tonight to go and be an encouragement. First and foremost, though, as you think about what you've experienced tonight, maybe you're sitting there and you're at a place where you want to know more about this Jesus that we have praised tonight. You have questions about what it means to follow Christ, who he is, what it looks like to walk with him. We would love to help you with that. Most important decision you can make of following Christ. And so if you would like to talk to somebody about beginning a relationship with God through his son Jesus, take a quick moment right now and take your phone out and text the word pastor to 334-384-8080. We will receive that text and one of our pastors will reach out to you in the days ahead to help you on this journey as you think about, first off, accepting Christ and knowing him and then walking with him every single day. And so do that for us tonight. Text the word pastor and let one of our staff reach out to you and help you in the days ahead. You can also text us tonight if you'd like to join our church. We are honored and just thankful for what God is doing in our body here at Ridgecrest, and all of us need to be a part of that. Need a Bible-believing, teaching church to be a part of. And we'd love to help you understand more about how you can be a part of our body here at Ridgecrest. So text the word join to the same number, 334-384-8080. And then lastly, maybe you're a guest of ours and you tuned in tonight for the first time and you just like more information about our church. We would love to help you with that. And so text the word guest to the same number, 334-384-8080, and we'll follow up with you as well. Again, it was a special evening, and our heart is this, as we wrap our time up together tonight, is what Psalm, again, 96, verses 2 and 3 say. Listen closely. Sing to the Lord, bless his name, proclaim his salvation from day to day, declare his glory among the nations. As we have proclaimed the glory of God tonight in song here on this campus or in the home that you find yourself in, our encouragement now is that you would go and proclaim and declare his glory among the nations. Declare that glory tomorrow at work. Declare that glory tomorrow at school. Declare that glory as you go through your everyday life and say, this is who my God is. This is what he's done. And give other people an opportunity to experience him and be changed by Jesus as well. Thanks so much for worshiping with us tonight. And as we think about our mission, I just want to remind you with it, as you think about declaring his glory among the nations, may God use you this week to reach the lost, build the believer, and connect the people of God to the mission and purpose of God. We love you guys.